Hello everyone, welcome to Luqman IAS. Today we are going to have the Hindu analysis of 17th November 2020. So let us see which are the important articles. Some important articles for mains purpose and some for prelims purpose. First of all, for mains purpose, article on page number 6, editorial. The context of the article is that whether India has missed the opportunity to join RCEP and whether RCEP was very much significant looking at the contraction in Indian economy at present and the lowering demand in the Western countries and how Southeast Asian countries and Eastern Asian countries are recovering or focusing on recovery of their economies and dealing effectively this COVID-19 pandemic and whether India has missed this opportunity to gain from this you can say RCEP grouping. This is what the article is discussing about. Okay, so yes, initially the article gives some basics about RCEP. Yes, Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership was signed into existence by 15 countries led by China, Japan, South Korea, Australia, New Zealand and 10 state ASEAN grouping. Okay, so yes, so India dropped out of it last year. Earlier also we have discussed basic about RCEP in previous lecture itself, so we will not go into details of that. But last year we withdrawn from the negotiations due to concerns related to various sectors including dairy sector especially. At the same time the heavy, we can say that the trade deficit among various nations especially China. So that's why we did not want to join this grouping. With global trade and economy foundering on the shoals of COVID-19 pandemic, especially new infections in Europe and US prompt fresh restrictions there, preeminence of East Asian and Pacific countries like China, South Korea, Vietnam, Australia, New Zealand serving the bulwark in containing pandemic and re-energizing economic activity can hardly be understated. Okay, so this is very important because these countries are effectively dealing with COVID-19 pandemic. At the same time they are focusing in recovering their economies. However, these Western countries, Europe and US, there are fresh waves of COVID-19 pandemic infections and therefore there may be restrictions. Adding to this, the heightened tariff uncertainty generated by deadlocked Brexit negotiations between Britain and EU, and it becomes evident that India may have missed the vital opportunity. Given that RCEP members now account for about 30% of the global GDP and third of world's population, the signatory states were emphatic that the timing of the accord presents unique opportunity to support their economic recovery, inclusive development and job creation, and it helps strengthen regional supply chains. This is very important statement in this article, the significance of RCEP. The summary of the final agreement shows that the pact does cover an attempt to address issues that India had flagged, including rules of origin, trade in services, movement of persons, and crucially, remedies and safeguards. So, this grievance redressal mechanism, remedies and safeguards were included in the final agreement. So, somehow the issues raised by India, some of the issues raised by India were addressed in this new agreement. Acknowledging that India's economic heft and value as the market, RCEP members have not only left the door open should the New Delhi reconsider its stance, but have also waived the key 18-month cooling period for interested applicants. So basically, it has made such provisions for re-entry of India, entry of India into RCEP grouping, looking at the huge market of India, at the same time the significance of India as a source of various goods and services. It would be India's interest to dispassionately review its position and embrace openness rather than protectionism. Very good statement that can be used when we talk about, let's say, addition to RCEP grouping or whether we want to sign this grouping or not. Fine. So from IAS perspective, this is very important, RCEP grouping. Judge recuses himself from Jagan case. Now this is the classic case of, we can say, conflict of interest or potential conflict of interest. This is topic in ethics subject GS4, and therefore we need to understand that what happened here. Supreme Court Justice UU Lalit on Monday recused himself from hearing separate writ petitions that sought actions against Andhra Pradesh government and Chief Minister YS Jagan Mohan Reddy. for leveling false, vague and political allegations against Supreme Court Judge N.V. Ramanna and other High Court judges. Okay, so explaining that he had, as a lawyer, represented some of the parties involved in the case, Justice Lalit, one of the few senior advocates directly elevated as Supreme Court in the history of court. Supreme Court. Okay, so he said that as a lawyer, he has represented some of the parties in the case, and therefore he recused from, let's say, sitting on the case or hearing the case. What do we mean by conflict of interest? In general, conflict of interest refers to deriving personal benefits out of decisions in official capacity. So this is in general conflict of interest, especially for public servant, civil servants, like public servants like judges. Okay, whenever there is a potential conflict of interest involved, person should disclose such conflict of interest and recuse from position of decision making or actions. Okay, so in the same situation at present, this Justice UU Lalit has disclosed this conflict of interest involved here and recused from the position to take any decision. Similar kind of cases can be for civil servants or other important positions, even in the corporate world. So conflict of interest should be avoided, and we can say that disclosure of such conflict of interest and recusal are important measures to avoid such conflict of interest. Okay, this is important from ethics perspective. Now, a very important article, we can say that what's behind the conflict between Ethiopian government and Tigray rebels. Now, this is in news since last 1 week, and yes, what is important for us is just briefly understand what is going on, but important for us is geographical perspective, location of Ethiopia, location of Lake Tana and the origin of Blue Nile River, and how Blue Nile River and White Nile River together converge into Sudan and then called as Nile River. All these things are important for our prelims perspective. So first of all, let us try to understand what is conflict going on in here. So Ethiopia's Nobel Peace Prize winning Prime Minister, Abiy Ahmed, started military operation in the rebellious Tigray region. Now, what is this Tigray region? This is given in this article itself. You can see here, this is Ethiopia boundary, here Eritrea, and this is the Tigray region. Okay, so deadly fighting in the region is facing thousands of Ethiopians flee to the border of Sudan. ठीक है, तो ये सूडान में यहाँ से बहुत लोग चले जा रहे हैं इथियोपिया के. यहाँ पे आपको लोकेशन लेक टाना का दिख रहा है. ओके, एंड अदिस अबाबा इज द कैपिटल ऑफ इथियोपिया. ओके, नो व्हाट इज टीपीएलएफ? टीपीएलएफ वाज फाउंडेड इन 1975 एज द रेजिस्टेंस आर्मी ऑफ टिग्रेन पीपल अगेंस्ट मिलिट्री डिक्टेटरशिप विच वॉज कॉल्ड डर्क. ओके, टिग्रे पीपल लिबरेशन फ्रंट. नाउ दिस प्लेड ए क्रूशियल रोल इन ऑस्टिंग जुंता, दिस मिलिट्री डिक्टेटरशिप, and they were welcomed as national heroes in 1991, and they formed a government, and the new government worked in the power until 2012. However, later on what happened is this government was criticized, or allegations were done for concentration of power, abuse of power and being increasingly authoritarian, and therefore to solve this political deadlock, in 2018 Mr. Abe was asked to lead the government, appointed as prime minister there. Now Tigray people make roughly 6% of the population, while Oromos 34% share and Amharas 27%, and these Oromos felt that their representation is less because this Tigrays being in the minority ruled the government. Okay, so this Prime Minister Abe, who belonged to this Oromos, okay, the country's first Oromos leader, Mr. Abe, so he reached out to Eritrea, sworn enemy of TPLF, which shares a long boundary with Tigray region. And for this purpose, the peace between this Ethiopia and Eritrea, he was awarded as Nobel Peace Prize. Okay. In August, when Mr. Abe's government decided to postpone parliamentary elections citing COVID-19, TPLF openly challenged the decision, and then they went on to themselves for their elections, regional elections in this Tigray region. Then in November 3, TPLF militants attacked federal military command in Tigray region and captured military hardware and equipment, prompting Mr. Abe to declare military operation. This is the military operation at present going on. Okay, there are some geopolitical angles involved here because there is border with Eritrea, Sudan. So if the Sudan government has border dispute with we can say Ethiopia, if Sudan government supports Tigray, then there will be again problem and escalation of conflict. So there are some situations wherein the region may experience again a civil war in future. Okay, so what is important for us geographical perspective, you can see here this is Lake Tana and Blue Nile River is originating from it. You can see this is Blue Nile River entering Sudan. Okay, and in similar way here in this map, it's you can understand that White Nile River originating from Lake Victoria like this and then entering into Sudan, and this Blue Nile River from Lake Tana in Ethiopia entering into Sudan, and their confluence after that the river is called as Nile River and draining into Mediterranean Sea. Okay, so this is important from geography perspective. So therefore the question can be asked like this. Consider the following statements. Blue Nile River originates from Lake Tana. Yes, this is correct statement. Lake Tana is located in South Sudan. This is incorrect statement because it is located in Ethiopia. So therefore incorrect. Blue Nile and White Nile River meets in Sudan. This is correct statement. So that's why answer is 1 and 3. Next, Gale completes Kochi-Mangaluru pipeline. So what is this pipeline and significance of it? From economic perspective, this is important because in Mangaluru there is a refinery and we can say gas plant is there, gas production plant, and therefore from Mangaluru to Kochi, this pipeline provides the gas supply to various 7 districts of Kerala, and therefore it has some significance. You can see here the coastal pipeline, and it is bifurcating here to supply here what we can say the gas to Bangalore city also. Okay, like this it goes like this, and therefore we can say that the line bifurcates at Kottanad to Mangaluru and Bangalore. Fine, so yes, this is important for we can say economic perspective. Yahan pe prelims ke liye aapko important hai that 444 kilometer long natural gas pipelines is important from transport perspective, and this is important in your GS3 paper mains examination. So what was the difficulty here? The 540 meter treacherous stretch across the Chandragiri river in northern Kerala. So yahan pe jo problem aa raha tha, that problem is now overcome, and therefore this pipeline is now completed. Gas Authority of India Limited, GAIL. Early data shows Moderna vaccine for 94.5% effective. This is again very good step, we can say development. It declared in initial, let's say, studies 94.5% effective vaccine. A similar kind of declaration was given by Pfizer that it is its own vaccine in collaboration with BioNTech. So that vaccine also was effective 90% and above. So we can say that the difference here is that Moderna also said that its vaccine has larger shelf life under refrigeration and at room temperature than the previously reported. So again, this is important in terms of infrastructure that we have here for refrigeration, or we say cold storage of vaccine. Yes, this is important statement. We can say that with respect to economy or trade, international trade, whether we should promote international trade or whether we should focus on only Atmanirbhar Bharat or we can say protectionism. So we should embrace openness rather than protectionism. This is what the article in the first related to RCEP it was talking about. Fine? Okay. So these were important articles from today's The Hindu newspaper. For further information on editorial discussion classes or ED classes, wherein in-depth analysis of all these mains related articles is done by Ansari sir and team, you can contact Lukman IS. Thank you.